The thing that I always hear from women is, how could somebody leave Teyana Taylor? And you don't know their relationship. You don't know anything about their relationship,
right.
Number one. Number two, just because somebody is hot, that doesn't mean they're a good partner that you have to spend the rest of your life with. You don't know.
Right.
That's not enough to maintain a relationship.
Hey, what's up, y'all? On this episode, we talk about how to avoid being in a reckless relationship and how women are not doing you a favor by having sex with you.
I'm not an alpha male. I'm not a beta male either. I'm just a better man. Better man.
Yo, 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 what up, Square Pimper Gay, GYBB, get your balls back, WWDD, what would Dante do, Sexual Revolutions being podcasted, and I am excited. Harry, what's popping, baby?
Oh, my goodness, Dante, I'm living the good life. If I was doing any better, I'd be a teacher with an OnlyFans page, all right?
What?
So that's the only way I could be doing better, because I guess that's what's going on now. I don't know if you know.
What are you talking about?
Well, listen, because America is the greatest country in the world, we all know
of
this.
Of course. Number one.
Nothing,
but still number one.
Still number one, depending on what you look at it. I mean, not happiness or health or
fentanyl.
Equality.
Number one fentanyl.
Yeah, number one. By a
opiate.
Lot.
We don't, I mean, opiate epidemic.
Opiate epidemic, we're number one.
Numero uno.
USA. USA.
USA.
And forgive me for my voice, man. It's a little messed up, but
nobody
we'll get through
knows it.
It.
Nobody even knows. Just
nobody knows.
Sound like you just this old whore that smokes a lot.
I sound like a teenage girl on day three of spring break. but so the teachers now, man, they don't have the money. We don't pay teachers properly. We don't pay them for school supplies. So now there is an epidemic going on.
An epidemic.
Teachers. I mean, every other day you see on social media, teacher fired for having OnlyFans page. Teacher fired.
Oh, yeah, that is true.
And the thing I keep thinking about, of course, is we all look back on all our teachers. I'm like, Jesus, I don't think one of mine would have qualified for an OnlyFans page.
I'm trying to think if I'd have.
I mean, we didn't
I had a Miss Babylonia, was a Spanish teacher, but she was.
Oh, Miss Babylonia sounds hot.
Babylonia, but she was just. She's as we say, she was a little long in the tooth.
Oh, okay. She might have been great for class of 69. Is that what you're saying?
69, class of 69. She was definitely good for
that
69.
Was her peak. But by the time you were there, Miss Babylonia was.
Or 68. I gave it to you, and you owe me one.
Oh boy. Not one of my teachers. I don't think there's one of my teachers that I'd want to see an OnlyFans page of, but I didn't have a ton of hot teachers. Maybe there was a couple of substitutes that made their way through every once in a while, but that was it.
I can't. Yeah, you're right. I remember Sister Pat Casey. We used to say she had torpedo tits because she was a nun and she had the mole haircut, just the bowl cut.
Okay,
but giant McGuffies, huge Jolos.
Oh boy!
Enormous milk wagons
that you could see through the because they wear those clothes that you can't really see much.
Yeah, but these was she had the old James Mansfield.
The bra
torpedo
those bras?
Bra, the pointy bras.
Oh yeah, well back then the bras were like that torpedo shape. That like yeah, that's the first inception of the bra.
Hers was a real torpedo, like the old school ones that they drop on Wile E. Coyote, those torpedoes like had to be triple G, U cup, something like that. Ridiculous. But
oh man, I didn't even have one. I don't think one. Anyway, though, the whole thing is you got these t-shirts, you see the pictures and all of them are pretty good. There hasn't been one yet that I've seen where you're like, oh damn. Like she's
like, I wouldn't hit that. You know what I mean?
No, they're all like, I guess it's a new generation of people who, anyway, these teachers, they don't make a lot of money, so now they're resorting to making OnlyFans pages because they don't have a choice for their income. They're going broke. They barely have enough. And so they're getting caught left and right. Every day there's another page of these teachers, and it's getting wild, man. It's getting wild. You're hearing about teachers all over the place doing stuff. Every day there's another one of some female teacher getting arrested for having, for extra lessons with the underage kids.
Trying to make meat ends. I mean, ends meet,
and
right?
Ends meet. And so, you know, yeah, man, it's wild. There was one that, this one in Ohio, I don't know if you saw this. There's a social worker in Ohio who was caught having sex with a 13-year-old she was counseling now.
Okay.
This is great. Like, this is.
So she wasn't a teacher, though. She was.
No, she was a social worker. Now they're not even waiting to teach. We don't even pay. We don't pay the social workers a lot either. There's a lot. There's going to be a lot of people with OnlyFans pages.
Is it a little bit worse that you go and it's a social worker? She's like, I advise you to eat this pussy. Like,
yeah, that's true. That is true. Well, let me see. I mean, that is a level of counseling. That you are it counseling. Is. It's just it a is. Different method of counseling. Let's pull
it
up this.
It just won't work in Jamaica because, you know, they don't bow cat.
Oh, they don't. You know. Oh, wait. In Jamaica, they won't go down?
You didn't notice?
I mean, I kind of knew this, but I didn't know that it was just Jamaicans. I mean, there's certain groups
of
people
Jamaicans,
that won't.
Well, Jamaicans, Trinidadians, Caribbeans.
The Caribbean.
Haitians, on the other hand, a little different. Haitians will, hey, do you ever have a man make love to you with your face, with my face? You ever make love to my face? Thank you. You ever Haitian man make love to my face twice?
Oh,
beautiful
boy.
Girl.
I didn't know that this about the Haitians. All right.
Oh, Haitians, they talk about their tongue very good. It's my fisherman's romantic and make love to you with my face.
Yeah, I want to see. Now I want to know which cultures don't service their women. Hold on. I'm going to look this up and see if there's an answer, because there's an answer to everything. Hold on. Which
you
country?
Make love to my face?
Okay.
I'm so a Haitian man.
I'm going to start with which countries don't eat pussy, but I'm sure that's going to be limiting. Limiting search-wise.
By Kalingus, which countries culturally frown on cunnilingus? You got to know.
Okay, this is from 2017. Which nationalities or cultures refuse to perform oral?
Okay.
Let's see. Oral and anal sex with
Google,
their husbands,
we love
and
you.
Why? What happened?
Google, we love you.
That Google is the best.
Put that in and get an answer.
Years ago, we just have to sit and ruminate and guess, but now we have an answer. This is just a public forum. This is not based. I want some science here. I don't need people guessing. Because then the related questions are, what would women rather do, suck dick or eat a vagina? You know, there's just, now it's becoming a free-for-all.
This
I want
is
some,
just reckless. This
yeah,
is
I want
reckless.
Some scientific method done with this. I need some control. I need a control. A thesis, a theory rather.
You need a control group. You need a scientific method is
all
what
right.
you need.
Maybe that's putting in, this is my fault. Which countries do not eat pussy? I'm going to adjust that and see if we could do, which countries don't.
Culturally, here's what you put. Which countries frown on culturally performing cunnilingus? There all you right, go.
Let's see here. Let's see. We have why we're having 14 types of blowjobs from I don't know. Oral sex.
Jesus Christ.
What I learned about hookup culture.
What's wrong with your algorithm?
I don't know. How common is oral sex? Let's see here. Maybe this will help here.
It can't be oral sex. It's got to be cunnilingus.
Yeah, you're right. Hold on. I'm going to change
it to cunnilingus.
Nobody calls
cunnilingus oral sex. They call munch in the box.
Here's the problem. I don't know how to spell cunnilingus. So now I'm just throwing
licking
this into
gash.
Google. And Google's not helping me.
Licking the honey pot.
Come on, Google. Give me an autocorrect here on cunnilingus. All right. You know what? This is going to happen.
Cunnilingus. C-U-N-I-L-I-N-G-U-S. Cunnilingus.
Well, so here's the problem here. I found this article. Cunnilingus. Is it a worldwide accepted practice? ? But it's on, right, which is fine. But it's the website is Men's Tennis Forums. I don't.
Listen, don't you disrespect those tennis dudes. They.
I guess that's what's going on. I got to start playing
those
more tennis.
Those guys are ace. Huh?
I got to start playing more tennis.
Those guys are ace.
They're ace. They are ace. And then, of course, Michael Douglas says cunnilingus gives you cancer. Okay, you know what? This we're going to have to revisit this because this is all over the place. Let's get back
right,
on
so
track.
This counselor.
Yeah,
she
let's.
Smashed a pristine little young 13-year-old.
And apparently not just one. So let's, let's
oh, this,
see here.
She's like a serial. Put
yeah.
the plate up.
Oh, yeah.
You
yeah.
got a video? You got a video?
Yeah. Hold
this?
On. I'm going to pull it up. Can you hear this?
Oh, is
a
this her?
Professor
I'm
with
in.
An apparent clown
no, that's
fetish.
Not her. That's just the reporter. Right. Sorry, bud. That's just the reporter. She has not apparently.
I am in.
Yeah.
A
let's
college
see.
Professor with an apparent clown fetish.
Oh, no, this is the wrong one. Sorry. That's another thing here. Hold on. That's another story.
A clown thing. We got to get back on.
We're going to get on that. I apologize. My algorithm is really messed up, Dante. This is your fault. I blame you and this show for ruining my algorithm. All right. This is the one. Sorry, folks. It was irresponsible. We are not talking about a clown fetish. We are talking about
will be talking about a clown fetish.
We will now.
All
right. We will be. I apologize for the clown fetish video. Let's get back to the real story. A social worker banging a 13-year-old. Sorry.
Let's go with the hard.
The hard news is literally the hard news. No soft
news
here.
This woman, 24-year-old Peyton Shires, faces an unlawful sexual conduct with a minor.
She's not bad looking. That's not bad for a social worker. That's not.
She looks
bad.
Like the chick from Hero.
Oh, that Hayden Panettiere.
Of course, you know that name. You filthy animal.
Oh, sorry. I fell right into that trap. You know who it was, but you're like smart. I think she's married to a boxer or something. I don't know. Anyway, Harry knows it. She's not. That's not bad looking. That's really good looking. And again, that's her mugshot too. So that's probably her at her lowest. She still looks doable.
She's done up.
Say the victim's a 13-year-old boy. Shires is a licensed social worker who works with youth, and police tell us she previously worked at National Youth Advocate Program.
Uh-oh.
Detectives say the victim was her counseling client.
Oh, no.
According to court documents, the victim's mom found text messages from Shires on her son's
phone. Stop that.
Okay.
Why are you cock blocking, mom? Come on. Put up or shut up.
These stories always go that way, by the way, Dante. Somebody's mother. It's never a concerned
never
father.
Because the father is going like.
The father saw it. He's like, listen, forward those to me and then delete them off your phone. But not before.
Let me get those.
Not before putting them on this fire, this hard drive. Just, you know, be smart.
Don't be reckless.
So the first thing you got to do is you got to make a folder called taxes, okay? But misspell taxes.
And he's going, you think you could introduce us?
Yeah, yeah. He's like, I want to go to parent-teacher night. Well, she's a social worker. What, they don't have parents can't come to the social worker?
I'm going. I
want to be
depressed.
Social.
Is there anything depressed. Wrong? Trying to get my credits up.
Let's see. Dad, let's
I'm sorry.
Back to it.
Phone asking if he mom found text messages from Shires on her son's
mom.
Phone asking if he deleted videos. The mom called police to get involved 2 days ago.
And how thrilled were the police to have to do this?
Oh,
they were
my
like,
God.
You fuck.
A lot of this going on.
A lot of elbowing. Hey, you know, who's got that assignment? A cock block? And you're like, this is not what we signed up for.
A detective says he found a video on a phone of Shires and the 13-year-old having sex in a controlled call with detectives.
First of all, just so you know,
we all know cops.
Yeah, rookie move number one. But by the way, that video made it around the precinct. Just so you know, more people. See, this is why you got to keep your mouth shut, moms. More people saw that video in a police locker room than
anybody else. She went viral. That video went viral in the police department.
In the Blue Lives Matter Reddit.
It's viral.
But it is a rookie mistake. It is a rookie mistake, Dante.
Stop videotaping yourself. First of all, none of you guys. I mean, we've had porn stars on here. That you don't have the equipment to do a porn that's going to be worth watching. You know, I mean, there's stops and pop shots and what was she? Sarah
J was going to be on the show.
Sarah J. She said that they have a fake pop shot that they do.
A fake cum shot.
You know that?
Yeah.
Yeah, they do a fake cum shot and they put it in a turkey baste and they squirt. I mean, it's just.
Yeah, it's hard to do. There's no reason. And stop watching your own.
And nobody wants to do that. You know that this thing like you have you ever had that thing where they got a hump with their arm behind their back?
That's a lot of those moves you can't do just physically. That's why anytime my chick you're watching a movie and they're fucking up against the wall and she's like that's you know like that.
Yeah, nobody's dick bends like that.
Nobody's it. You have to have like a 10-inch cock to
do that. You gotta have a 13 to make that to make that corner, my friend.
And not just that, you need core strength, upper body. That's not. Yeah. It ain't going down like that. That's why.
Let me just say this for the record, but remind me this: why women fucking you is not a gift. But I'll remind me of that after. But go ahead.
Hold on. Why women fucking you is not a gift. Here, let's get back to finishing this.
Is he coming? Yeah.
Admitted to having sex with the victim multiple times
on
a phone of Shires and the 13-year-old having sex. In a controlled call with detectives, court documents reveal Shires admitted to having sex with the victim multiple times.
She admitted having sex multiple times.
Multiple times. Bitch, deny. What's wrong with you? Yo, how many times have you said this, that somebody you got... It was only once.
Yeah.
It was just once.
I don't think they're going to be any more, you know, they're not going to be any more lenient or, you know, you're still going to jail whether you lie. They're not going to be like, well, you know, she did have sex with an underage child, but at least she's honest about it.
But you know what?
That's going to count for something.
It was, let's be honest, it was only once, you know, it was only once. But, oh my God. Well, now, you know, I got to, so let me just say this. This is a thing when women think that they're giving you by they're doing you a favor by fucking, right? I will profess to this, and I'm not saying that there's not exceptions to the rule, but I've never ever ever had a woman have sex with me or F me more for longer than I've F'd her. Never.
Explain that now. What are you saying?
So If you're putting the D down, if you know what I'm saying, and the amount that you are the active effer, right, always exceeds the fact that the girl reciprocates back. Like, I've never had a girl ride me longer than I was effing her.
Okay, all right. It's always work as a man. I mean, it's always
right. And even when she's riding you, you're still arching your back, kind of meet her and still working from the bottom.
You gotta adjust the position so that, you know, you get the leverage on her.
Because we do. Remember we had that dude on here who broke his dick?
I do remember that. Yeah, I'll never forget. I think about that dude once a week. That's a horrifying story.
Did he? Do you remember what just screwed us up to the no end?
What?
That he went to pee and his penis just like blew up. It just splatted blood all over the place.
Oh, Jesus.
Do you remember that?
Yeah, I do remember that. Let me look up which episode that is, but that'll be in the archives there.
Which we are uploading on the Patreon, patreon.com, manschool202. We are uploading all the old episodes so you can get back to all the old episodes and whatnot that you haven't seen from the time. Even the old audio, before we had enough money to buy a camera.
So if you love what we're doing, patreon.com/manschool202 to subscribe and support us. I'm trying to find that episode, but go on with what you were saying, Dante.
The broken dick dude. But yeah. But this is the thing. When a girl thinks that she's doing you a favor by giving you some booty, what she's not doing is what they never work or expend as much energy as you do because of the fact that. And this is proof of this. Here's my proof. I don't have this is not something that's scientifically proven. It's one of those things I just know are true. I can't prove it, but I just know it's so.
Okay.
If you ever watch a video of a girl on girl strap on porn, or so I've heard. I've never seen it myself, but
you don't watch such things.
You can literally count. Count the number of strokes that the girl, the girl who's the effer, right, does to the effie, because women most of the time don't have the core strength or the hamstring core strength or upper body strength to do it. So, I mean, we've been, you know, humping stuff since the beginning of time, which gives us the intricate and small synergistic muscles that allow us to move our pelvis in ways that in a F pattern, if you will. And so if you could never, if you look at a porn movie and you watch a guy screwing a girl, or you watch a girl screwing a girl on a strap-on, or even, not my thing, but even a girl pegging a dude, you could literally count the strokes, the hump strokes for a girl.
It's not as many. You ever see that video? I got to find that. But there's a TikTok video where the guy makes the woman just get in the position, like clothes on, no sex.
Oh, yeah.
How long she can go. And she's like, oh, this is hard. He goes, yeah, you see? You see? You keep shouting faster, harder. You see? No, keep going. Faster, harder. Keep going.
Yeah. And then you're a loser because you can't go.
Yeah, the whole point of that is that, you know, we put sex on such a high platform, right? We value it so highly that guys do anything and everything just to be able to have sex with a woman, that it's still work that you have to do. So the prize you're bidding on is always more work, and we forget about that. So like dating a hot, attractive woman, it's more work. It is more work. And so,
and even a threesome is more work.
It's
more
crazy work amount of work. You gotta satisfy two women in that situation.
And if it goes to shit, it's your fault.
Right.
If it goes nobody to blames shit, the girl.
If it goes to shit, it's your fault. Right. And also, when you do a threesome, there's certain protocols you gotta follow, which we've talked about, which is
shout
you gotta take
to
care
Cinnabon
of your girl first.
that guys never listen when you give them the protocol. I actually had one of my consultations, DanteNero.com, click on consult. You can give me a consultation if you want there. Harry is advice from Harry.
Yeah, you can email me at advicefromharry@gmail.com if you want a relationship consultation. But you were doing a consultation.
But one of the guys, one of the old school listeners, when he had his first, I was working on him, and he had his first threesome, and I absolutely told him that specifically everything that happens goes through the girl that set up the threesome. So the girl that sets up the threesome, you kiss her first, you fuck her first, you eat her first, you do everything you do, you lead off.
She
with
gets
her,
your cum.
Right, she gets the cum shot. Unless she wants to pass it off, she can.
But that has to be very much implied and confirmed that she wants that passed off.
She
yeah.
The senator from fucking, she can relinquish her time.
Yeah.
She can yield
she can
the time
relinquish
if she
her
wants.
Cum.
If she wants to, but everything goes to her because the science behind it is that the theory is that she is allowing this and setting it. She's always the girl that sets it up too. Mm. You don't go and get, yo, I got this chick that wants to F us. You let her set it up. I mean, now once you have an understanding, you know, the roles can change if you're into that, but usually that's usually not going to be your that very rarely is your routine where you both can chip in on the on who's involved in the threesomes.
So the thing I'm talking about with the we forget that the prize that you're seeking as a man when you're going after a woman is more work, right?
Yeah,
that's the weird part about it. It's like getting a big promotion and then like, all right, now you have to actually do the job.
Right.
Because a relationship is work. A relationship is work. Maintaining the relationship, her happiness, focusing on that, taking her out even. You know, you have to have a plan. Even if she says she wants to plan things, she doesn't. She wants you to plan. She just doesn't know to say it out loud. You know, it's all stuff you have to do. You have to make it fun. Because if shit goes down and it gets bad, you take the blame for it. You're the one who ends up getting the blame. So it leads me to something else, which I find very interesting. When you talk about all the celebrity gossip that ends up happening and these breakups that happen, it's always funny the reaction. So Shakira just got divorced from her husband, soccer player David Pique. And he cheated on her. And in this thing, you know, I'm a Shakira fan, but just breaking it down, you know, within an unbiased...
Shakira's a smoker. She's absolutely a smoker.
She absolutely is. Breaking this down, the dude's an asshole. David Pique is an absolute asshole. He's a young guy who got married, probably shouldn't have gotten married. He's a young guy in his 20s, wants to fuck around, and so he ended up doing that, and it's wrong. He's a liar. He took a vow. He broke the vow. He's a liar, and then afterwards, he's shitting on Shakira publicly, which is the mother of children. Yeah, yeah. In a press conference, he's one of those guys. His move is the best defense is a good offense.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So he's like going in on her. Best, you know, screaming, like talking about how boring she was, and that's why they don't have a relationship, because she was boring, and then she, you know, whatever. It's the mother of your kids. You made that choice. If you don't like it, you can get divorced.
Okay, but here, let's okay.
But I'm getting a little lost in the weeds here.
Being this devil's advocate, right? Being devil's advocate, when you watch Shakira dance and perform, there is a level of expectation, right, about her sexually and stuff, because she exudes this kind of sexuality. Is he saying that she was just boring in general? Or?
He's saying he wanted to go out and she was like in bed by 6 and stuff like that, you know, just things like that. And if that's the case and you're not happy with it, you have to have that conversation with your partner. Yeah. But I don't believe that happened. I believe he just cheated on her.
And he's looking for a way out.
Just trying not to take responsibility, and he's an asshole. But the point is in Teyana Taylor. You've seen Teyana Taylor, right? Smoke Show.
Yeah.
Smoke Show. She and her husband just recently split. No infidelity or anything. She's confirmed that. The thing that I always hear from women is, how could somebody leave Teyana Taylor? Like, if Teyana Taylor can't, you know, how could somebody leave her? And you don't know their relationship. You don't know anything about their relationship,
right?
Number one. Number two, just because somebody is hot, that doesn't mean they're a good partner that you have to spend the rest of your life with. You don't know.
Right.
That's not enough to maintain a relationship.
Right, right.
You don't know what her personality was. You don't know what was going on in that relationship. And I'm not blaming her, because I don't know anything about their relationship. But what I do know about their relationship is I know nothing about their relationship.
Right.
It's the same thing. Women tend to do this a lot. They tend to look at another couple and go, wow, I wish we were like them. I wish, you know, and it's like, you don't know anything about their relationship. We see them in public. And then when somebody gets divorced, they go, oh, I don't know why. I don't understand it. You don't know anything.
And there's an absolute sense of, you know, it's Instagram dope. It's like, you're only seeing the best of them. You're not seeing the worst of them. I mean, you know, I without a doubt, I don't advocate any abuse or anything with women at all. But Halle Berry, every dude she was with was physically abusive, right? Mm. So I get that no man should hit a woman or whatever. But also, if we have a pattern, I know I'm. You know, I'm on a tightrope this, but if there's a pattern of this behavior over and over and over again, then she's picking dirtbags. So there's something about something with her that she keeps picking these abusive men.
There's an aspect to that. Sure. Yeah. You have to wonder why what's going on? What trauma is leading you to pick bad partners, for sure. Doesn't excuse a physical abuse by any means, but by the fifth time it happens, you have to introspectively look at yourself. But it is, again, like, how could someone leave Halle Berry? She's so beautiful. It's not just about beauty.
Yeah.
You know, it's beauty and sex, that's one aspect of it. But the most important thing that men want or should want is peace.
Yeah.
Is peace of mind. Just clarity, no drama. You know, those are things that really, I've been in relationships in the past with real smoke shows, attractive women, and it didn't work because they didn't give me peace. So they ended up out the door because that's more valuable to me.
Yeah.
Now, other guys, you know, we were talking about like alpha male or whatever, what a clown he is, where he's talking about, you just lie, whatever I got to do to get the pussy. I just lie, cheat, whatever. Just I say what I got to say, whatever I have to do. And, well, congratulations. Number one, you're a liar. But number two, you're not maintaining anything. Like, how are you supposed to maintain anything if it's all based on a lie?
I mean, and in his defense, that's what he says. I'm trying to get laid and keep it moving. I don't understand why you would reduce your entire life to sex with a woman. I don't understand how you what kind of human being are you that in terms of the cultivation of your own personality and who you are, that is how you validate yourself, is how many women you sleep with. The only person that does that is somebody who has a problem sleeping with women, you know, or somebody that values that in a way as if that this is a woman accepting you in that, in an intimate way, validates you in some sense. And if that's the case, then you don't really see yourself as validated in any other way other than that. If that's the sole way in which you're validated, it says something about you. And to be honest, when you lie, you get laid more when you tell the truth. I say this all the time. Said this on the show. If you're a liar, when you tell her you love her, when you tell her you got her back, how does she ever believe you? She can't. She cannot believe you because it's the Judge Judy effect. It's like anytime you get caught in the lie in the beginning of Judge Judy, you've lost the trial already because you have no credibility.
How can she believe anything else you say? And she literally says that. I can't believe a word you're saying.
That's absolutely interesting. But just keep in mind, if you guys love what we're doing and you want to support us, please check out our Patreon. It's patreon.com/manschool202. Support us there. That's the best way to support us so we can keep doing what you want to do, what we've been doing and putting out great content.
That's where we do all our stuff. This week, we're doing bonus content where we're dealing with someone else's trauma and how to set boundaries with other people. Plus, we are also downloading all the episodes of the archive starting from episode one, and you can find them exclusively at patreon.com/manschool202.
And also, if you need a consultation, you can hit me up at dantenero.com and click on consult. Everything is there, or you can hit Harry.
advicefromharry@gmail.com is where you can email me if you want relationship advice. So the thing is, man, and it's weird because what happens is for some reason it transitions from sex, right, to say anything to have sex. And then you get with a woman and you're in a relationship, you get married. And then it becomes, I'll say anything just to have peace.
Right.
And that's bad too, because you're just lying and you're not putting your partner in check if they need to be put in check. And that leads to just a lot of bad relationships. And by the way, your woman doing that, you know, somebody or your partner doing that doesn't just affect you. It affects the people around you who have to be around that person. As well, whether it's your family or your friends, somebody who's reckless affects you and your friends.
Yeah. Shout out to Corey Holcomb. Corey Holcomb was talking about that, how you get somebody in a comedy club and she says something slick to you. And then when you put her in her place, then all of a sudden the guy was like, yo, don't be talking to my woman like that. And then, but you have no problem with her walking all over you, disrespecting you in any way possible. And then somehow in the grand scheme of things, because you don't have no respect for yourself, now I'm supposed to treat her the same way that she's accustomed to, because she's accustomed to you being, she's accustomed to you taking her disrespect all the time. And now all the men around are supposed to do the same thing because she has you accepting that. So she assumes that every man is going to accept that. It goes back. I just got a question from one of the guys who I consult with. He was saying, do you still advocate the fact that anytime you do something more than three times is no longer a favor, it's an obligation? So
absolutely.
Let me say that again. Anytime you do things more than three times, it's no longer an obligation. It's not longer a favor, it's an obligation. The first time you do it, it's like, oh, wow, that was so great. The second time is like, oh, this is dope. But then you start to get expectation. And then the third time, it's mandatory. This is what you do. This is the standards that you set. So I got a question about that on the Patreon. And because naturally, anybody who just so y'all know, when you're on the Patreon, they send me questions directly and we answer them as quickly as we get them, because it's a tier of where we, you know, you support us and we interact with you.
Yeah. And if you want to support the show and you love, you want bonus content about dating tips and relationships, patreon.com/manschool202. That's where we do bonus shows, like another bonus show we're going to do this week after this one.
But this is a situation where you can do, I'm not saying you shouldn't do favors, but when there is a favor and you're doing something that you don't want to do, it should be clear that this is not what you want to do. It should be understood that this is not really my cup of tea, but if you want me to go, I'll go. But at least there's an understanding of the fact that I am making a compromise, and I want you to understand that I am making a compromise, because if you don't do that, if you don't make that clear, then your compromising and your constant compromising becomes an obligation, that your needs and your problem, your what you do doesn't matter as long as you're doing what she wants to do. And then she takes that for granted. And don't get me wrong, you know, that can happen on either side, on both sexes, that can happen. But what happens is, because of the fact that I think that men are accustomed to being in that. And so when people do stuff for them, they deal with it. I mean, but don't get me wrong. I've seen men take things for granted, you know.
Sure, men can take things for granted, for sure. Yeah, without a doubt. I mean, and anyone can. But the thing is, in the confines of a relationship, certain things just become non-verbally an expectation from a woman.
Yeah.
And then they begin, a thing that you did as a favor or a one-off has now become, you're expected to do that. And if you're not doing that, you're somehow
something wrong with you. You've fallen off.
Yeah, you've fallen off. And you get this energy as if you're doing something wrong. And that becomes the problem within the relationship, which is you have this constant energy of you're doing something wrong that you never agreed to in the beginning. And whatever that is, that's up to you, whether it's cleaning up around the house every day, or whether it's attending events that you don't want to attend, seeing family members you don't want to see. It all becomes an expectation to them unless it's verbally talked about. Nobody talks about it. So you have to be the one to go, I don't want to do this. I'm not interested in doing this. If we do this, it's a favor for you. And I'm fine
doing
that.
Did you see that video? See if you can find that video. There's a video of the guy, man and a woman. The man, they get married, and the priest is going through. Did you see this?
I did not see
this. The priest is going to love, honor, and obey. And then she goes, when he says obey, she hesitates. And then he says, in sickness and in health. Richer or poorer, and then she hesitates. And throughout the whole time that this woman is going through her vows, she is hesitating. She's hesitating, and they're laughing, you know, like the crowd
like
is laughing.
Joke. Yeah.
The crowd is laughing and he's laughing, and it's all funny. But once this $5,000 wedding dress comes off, and you're in this apartment, and y'all are living with each other, you already know that he is basically signing up for a situation where he's either going to be a dude who works the rest of his life to appease her and to genuflect with her nonsense and her whatever her selfishness is, or he's going to be divorced. And I don't even think that we're literally talking about this woman. They're getting married. They're doing their vows. And she doesn't even have the respect for him to even like not. She's not even. Which I respect the fact that she's not lying about it. She's not misrepresenting herself. She's saying, look, and then the preacher is like, we talked about this. And she goes, love, honor, and obey. And then she goes, we didn't talk about it. Yes, we did. The preacher goes, yes, we did talk about it. Blah, blah, blah. And you're looking at this and you're going, how could this marriage ever work when somebody is at this level where she is basically not even coming? She's not even coming into this relationship with a good faith attitude. That she's trying to make it work.
See if
she's
I can
already
pull it up. I'm trying to find it, but
but
it's a red flag. And then what happens is you go, oh, I didn't see it coming. How did you end up in a divorce, or you end up fighting? You go, what happened? What do you mean? What happened? You saw who this person was. You just chose to ignore it.
Yeah, you know? Think it was on Instagram.
I think I found a copy here on the TikTok here, on the TikTok is how the kids call it. Here, let's pull
it
up.
That's what they call it.
That's what they call it.
Yes, that's it.
That's the one, right?
Sure.
Lay that.
For richer?
For poor.
For poorer.
For poor.
For poorer.
For poorer.
Yeah, everyone's laughing, but it's
oh, it's a joke.
Yeah. We hit that snag about 20 times in counseling.
In counseling.
Big Wait. Joke.
I made it very clear to Jonathan, you cannot be broke. Yeah. And in health.
And in health.
To love.
To love.
Cherish.
Cherish.
And to obey.
Twice.
We didn't talk about that one in counseling.
We did talk about that in counseling.
Oh, wow.
Yes, we did.
Oh, you didn't see this.
No,
so
I didn't see this
part. Repeat that again, you want to just keep going?
I think we can keep going.
I think we can keep going. Okay.
For work.
For richer.
Wow.
For
rich. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. That's just. So what is that relationship going to be like, right? And I know what that relationship is going to be like, because there's another TikTok video I'm going to pull up if you want to vamp a little bit. But
oh, this is the one with the, Beyonce. Filipino?
No, the Beyonce tickets.
Oh.
The what? Beyonce
okay. Oh, yeah.
You know, but the point is, number one, this is a big red flag at the wedding. But yeah. I guarantee you there were red flags before this that let
all
you know
way,
this
all
woman
the way up
was,
until
a,
the wedding.
Was a gold digger. And listen, I don't believe in the vow. I'm not a religious guy just like you.
Yeah.
But you've been to a wedding. You know what these vows are. You know what this is.
Right. This is a show for everybody else so that you can do and be and perceive yourself in the way that you want to perceive yourself and how people want to see you. This is your day that you're spending tens of thousands of dollars to advocate your day that you which usually is, you know, I absolutely feel it's a waste of money, but okay, this is important to you, whatever. And then you can't even be agreeable in the context of this whole thing in the first place.
Yeah.
It's insane.
It's your thing. It's the your religious beliefs. But also like it also it's interesting because I mean they're just words, right? I don't know. They're words to me. They're a vow that you're taking religiously, which is your choice. To do that, you know, going into it, but they're just.
But even
words.
If it's not religious, it's still a vow. It's we talk about being honest and authentic and truthful, you know. So if you're saying this, you're saying this. And if you can't say this, and the fact that he's laughing, it's like it's the whole this is such a big joke until they're going through divorce. They have kids and then you got to split up the kids and you can't, you know, the you know, whatever the situation or that's it's not beneficial for the family and for just stop marrying this awful woman.
Stop dating her. Stop dating her. Stop marrying her. Stop talking about her, because I guarantee you this happened before. And this is what ends up happening. I'm going to pull it up. This is how this ends up happening.
You know that you stole money out of my account. That was money for my kid, heart surgery.
Why is you recording me right now? Like, you trying to...
This is, it says, wife uses child surgery money for Beyonce ticket. So, this is his daughter. He was raising money for his daughter's...
Yeah, her stepdaughter.
Her stepdaughter, but his biological daughter.
Yeah.
Raising money, saving an account for her surgery. She took money out of that account to go get Beyonce tickets. And he confronts her, and this is the type of attitude she has about that.
Why are you filming me?
Yeah.
You know that you stole money out of my account? That was money for my kid, heart surgery?
Why is you recording me right now?
Why is you recording? You
don't worry about why I'm recording you. I don't worry about what my money is.
Like, I begged you to take me to that concert. Why wouldn't you take me to the concert?
Because the concert is the least of my
Look,
worries right now.
I don't
right
care
now.
About that. Like,
my kid heart surgery is what I'm worried about right now.
Look, like,
and for you to take my money out of my account just to go to some Beyonce concert, you'd have lost your mind.
I don't care.
I don't care.
Mm.
I don't care. Could you imagine having
you
a conversation?
You awful human being.
I don't
you
care.
You wretched harpy. You, you know,
I
it's
mean,
just like,
it's just the worst human being alive to go, this dude is raising money for his own kid. And when he confronts her, she acts like he's the problem.
Why is you taping me?
How do you ever, how are you married to her in the first place? How does this ever?
I didn't even know if he's married, but the
no,
fact
it's, it says
that
wife.
He has, oh, that is his wife.
It says wife. Well, you know, it's TikTok, so maybe it's inaccurate, but my understanding is even, I mean, if it doesn't matter. We're into semantics. The wife
for Beyonce
no wife,
tickets.
But for Beyonce tickets. I mean, I don't understand if it was Taylor Swift tickets. Now, listen, here we go. All right. Send your
there you
hate
go
mail.
With your white goggles.
Boy, white goggles. I'm a Swifty through and through. All right, here we go.
I don't care what you don't care about.
You don't have a voice like right now.
Owe me my money.
Ask your baby mom.
She ain't got nothing to deal with this. Nothing to deal with it. Go find me my money.
For money, like, why y'all don't have money? Like,
I don't need to go to concert. You, they ain't got nothing to do with my wife right now.
I mean, you never take me nowhere.
It's his wife.
I wanted to go to the concert, and I went.
Because why would I take you somewhere when something is important? Why would I take someone? Why would I spend my hard-working money? That was my hard-working money for my kid so he could have a life.
I don't care.
I don't care.
So he could have a life, and she goes, I don't care.
I don't care. I don't know how.
But it ain't her fault.
No, it's his fault.
It's his fault, honey. And guys get upset when I say, when this happens, this is your fault. This is something that you saw. I could see don't get me wrong. We all get to a point where we're overlooking, or this is why you can't let emotion have a seat at the table, because she's hot. She's a cutie. It's you all into this, and you're overlooking these things. You're overlooking these situations where you literally get grinded down to a point where it's not even about how hot she is no more. You're let just in survival mode.
Unacceptable behavior.
Literally looking for peace of mind now. Let's run it to the end. Let me see the end.
Yeah,
of it.
I mean, just wall to wall red flags to the point where you end up. By the way, just to your point, it is absolutely his fault, because this was not the first time like this happened.
No, because nobody's that arrogant and that far off
that the first awful thing they do is you stole somebody else's money from a fund to save a dying sick child. That's not your first.
Yeah, that's not your first
evil deed.
That's not even the fifth. That's right. Not the eighth, really.
Right. That's not the first time this shit has happened with their relationship here. Hold on, let me pull up the rest of it here. Let's
crazy
see.
Though. It's just
yeah.
I don't care what you don't care about. You got to care about my kid. That's what you need to care about.
Because
what if this was your life?
Mom,
what if this was your life?
Your baby
what if this
mom,
was your life? I came to your house.
Your baby mom needs to take care of her kids.
My baby mama ain't doing nothing right now.
Exactly. So go bother her. Like,
go bother
I don't
her.
Need to bother her. Why would I bother somebody that ain't doing nothing for me?
Like,
why would I bother somebody that ain't doing nothing for me right now?
Bro. Like,
you need to go find my money.
No, I'm not.
That's what you need to go find. You need to go find my money.
Mom.
I don't care what you gotta do. You better sell something. You better go find my money.
Ask your baby mom.
I ain't gotta ask her nothing. You better go find my money. That's what you need to do.
I'm not giving you your money.
Why you staying here talking? Go find my money.
I'm not giving you your money.
Go find my money.
I can't get a refund on it.
I don't care what you gotta do to get my money.
Just.
I'm not giving you your money. And that statement is so telling. I'm acknowledging that this is your money, and I'm taking it anyway.
And then just everyone but her is responsible. Every solution is, and it's also, but this is also, you didn't set the boundaries and the parameters and set up the importance of your relationship with your child over her. Because I guarantee this is not the type of person.
Yeah.
I've been in relationships with women who have children, and I've set up whatever my parameters are with them, whether I'm involved or not. But what I don't do is pretend that everything is good, that we're going to get married.
Yeah.
To somebody who has kids, and then I'm going to look at those kids as they're not mine.
Mm-hmm.
That can't happen.
Yeah.
That just
because even if you do, they infringe, their lives infringe upon yours no matter what.
Well,
no
at the very least, they're going to coincide. You have no choice.
I mean, if you're a decent human being, it has to.
Unless he's an absentee father. And then if he's an absentee father, that's not the type of person you want to be with to begin with.
And to be honest, what kind of mother would be with a guy who you're in a long-term relationship with a guy who doesn't want to be involved with your children to whatever extent it is? What kind of mother is that you that you think that you can keep this separate? You know,
well, she did. Apparently she did.
And here's the crazy. Here's a thing that I don't think you even thought about. She's saying, well, talk to your baby moms. She ain't doing nothing. So this is a pattern of the type of women that he's choosing.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
That's choosing, another one. You know what I'm saying? That's the part we're missing, is that here's a guy who is who has already chose to have a child with a woman who this kid apparently needs a heart surgery, who's willing to do nothing, that he can't even go to her to come together for the health of the child. And then he grabs another one who's just as
awful,
uninvolved and awful and selfish as the one that he had the baby with.
Yeah, this goes back to him. It's not even her fault. Let's see if there's anything else. There's another about another 26 seconds here. I think maybe they'll get it together. Maybe we'll see something.
You think it's all going to turn around?
It'll turn around. It's TikTok. You know, they'll flip the music and they'll say that they're happy.
I have fun and you don't even take me nowhere.
This is my kid. This is my kid.
I beg you to take me to
my
the movie.
My kid. You need to understand, this is my kid.
Okay, but
this is my kid.
No, back up.
I don't care.
But no,
you need to buy my money.
Ask your baby mom.
Buy my money.
I don't care. Like, she don't do nothing for you or your kid. Like, what?
Yo, he's going at her the same way like they do those, like, Crime Stoppers will show up at like a mechanic auto shop and go, "Why? Yeah. Where's our money? Why didn't you pay the full amount of money?
You think it's right to just charge somebody for a transmission and then all you did was change the transmission oil?
Yeah, why didn't you finish this bathroom?"
Do you think I care about my baby mama right now? Do you really think I care? Do you really think I care?
Because
I ain't got nothing to deal with her. Like, this is about you taking my...
What is you coming at me for?
What is you coming at me for?
Yeah, I think... didn't Mussolini say that before they hung him?
I think it was Kolkar.
Oh, okay. That makes more sense.
You get them all mixed up.
I do mix them up.
There's we gotta go to the Patreon, but I got a story. I just went through one of these situations with a longtime friend of mine and his reckless ass wife.
Yeah. You had to call him out.
Well, let's don't forget, guys, please sign up for the Patreon. You help us out so we can keep doing this and keep bringing this to you. You know how to
patreon.com.
All the stuff will be down in the description in the description of the video and everything. Patreon.com/manschool202. Please support us. GYBB, get your balls back. WWDD, what would Dante do? The Sexual Revolution is being podcast. We love y'all. See y'all on the Patreon side.
I'm not an alpha male. I'm not a beta male either. I'm just a better man.
Better man.
Put your happiness first, because if you don't, they won't.